Welcome to the World United.
Welcome to the World United.
So our next speaker is Datta Prasad Bhonsle. I would like to do a introduction for sir. Thank you so much, sir, for being our second speaker.
You're most welcome.
So here it goes. This is sir's introduction. Heartfulness meditation. He's a trainer for the past 5 years, belonging to the Heartfulness Institute, Hyderabad, Telangana. He's worked as a senior vice president, supply chain management in a private sector with 35 years of experience on supply chain management and also spirituality. Teaching how to meditate with yogic energy is something dear to his heart and is one of the ways he feels can help humanity cope with today's stress. They don't charge any fees. It is completely free of cost and they teach meditation. So sir's topic for today is heartfulness meditation for well-being. So over to you, Datta Prasad Bhonsle, sir.
Thank you, Sharvitaji. Pranams to elders and dear sisters and brothers. I've been already introduced, but I would just want to share some inputs about this organization which I belong to. My voice is clear, I hope. Yeah, okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we are based out of Hyderabad, Telangana, and we are across 160 countries by now. We practice meditation based on yogic energy, heart-based meditation. And we try to bring awareness around the purpose of this meditation, spirituality, consciousness, meditation, then doing simple practices. Okay, and we are also known as Sahaj Marg Spirituality Foundation. I will now give some inputs on how this meditation would help as humans and how we can overcome the situations what we are facing in the last 2 years. If you look at last 2-3 years in the world situation, it has affected us so much. And well-being is a big question today. So now let's look at the basic types of well-being we look at. We have physical well-being, we have financial well-being, we have social well-being, which is a new thing, which was not there during my period of time when I was a kid. Because, you know, social FOMO, I mean, most of us have heard about FOMO, right? Fear of missing out. This is being a very particular thing in today's youth. You notice that they want to see how many of likes are there on their Facebook or Twitter, how many followers are Twitter. And if it doesn't happen in half an hour or so, they get stressed out. They get stressed out of just being not liked. And this is also a problem. And then we have mental well-being. Now, last 10 to 12 years, the social well-being and mental well-being has been a problem. In the last 2 years, particularly, mental well-being has been something which is to be seen and looked at very seriously. And look at the mental well-being. You know, what is mental health, or what we call as I'm mentally well? You know, one of the characteristics or what we could see is we are all meditators in an organization. I need not elaborate on this more, but I can tell you what. Feeling happy, peaceful, satisfied, deep compassion, especially deep compassion for others, able to sleep deeply. Even if you are allowed to sleep on a stone, you will be able to sleep very well on that stone. These are the characteristics of a good mental health. And that's the opposite. Lack of sleep, high irritability, uncontrolled emotion, the list goes on. Okay. Now, mental well-being is directly connected to our mind. If you're able to manage our mind well, I said manage your mind, not control. If you manage your mind well, then we are on track. How do you do that? Now let us understand the mind first. Okay. It's very difficult because the mind itself has no place in our system. I mean, where can you find it physically? It's not there. So let's look at how the mind is, and let's look at the human system. As humans, we are well-developed system. We call it the physical body, the sthul sharira, which we have. We have subtle body or astral body or a mental body, which is also called as sukshma sharira. And we have causal body, that is karan sharira, that's the soul, the pure. Now, these are also present in all the kingdoms, like mineral, plant, animal kingdom, but they are not manifested to the extent as it is in humans. The physical body we have, but we can't do much about it because it is there. It is genetically there. We can at the most do some changes, like doing some exercises to become thin or gain weight, do some changes in our, but that is a limitation to it. Now look at the causal body, which is pure and divine. It's a soul that's God given. Now what's left is the subtle body. The subtle body is the one which evolves as we meditate. Now this, if you look at subtle body, it has got four parts, subparts. There are much more, but we look only at the four ones which are very important. Okay? Chitta, manas, buddhi, ahankar. Consciousness, mind, intellect, ego. Consciousness is what? Degree of awareness. That's the shortest definition I could look at. It's the degree of awareness or degree of unawareness. Okay? Manas is mind which thinks and gives options. You know, it thinks. Mind, its job is to think. So it will think in all directions. It is either in the past or the future, or, you know, it tells you you are sick. So that is mind. Intellect is what? Intellect is thing. It gives you the option. It tells you this is what you have to do. And ego, ahankar, is the one which executes or not. If you do it or not do it, the decision is ego's. So mind is like a monkey always jumping from one thought to another, past and future. And that's a job. I mean, mind has to think. But it is unregulated. If you're able to regulate the mind, then it's done, right? I mean, if you tell them to think in a right direction, but how do you do that? Okay, I will give you an example. How to regulate the mind? Before I come to that, I'll give an example. We are traveling in a flight. All of us do travel in a flight or a bus or a train. And you're sitting on your seat and you look at the people coming. Just by looking at the people, you have already decided this guy is stressed out. This guy is going for a meeting, or this lady is going for a wedding. On the way the person behaves, the way he's dressed up, and similar, so many other things, you already judge a person. You don't know the person, you don't know anything about that person, but you already judged him. Another example is, let's say you're traveling, four of your friends are traveling in a car, and someone overtakes from the left side. What you would react? I would be angry. Somebody will say, well, maybe he's in a real hurry, let him go. The third person may just say, okay, leave it, forget it. Now, for the same event, you have three different types of reactions. Why? Now I come to this, what is known as impressions. All of us are built up from our young days or our past experiences, past impressions. We have built up all these impressions in our mind. These are impressions, sanskaras, which are there stored in our system, which gives us the reaction. These are filters. We look at every event through these filters. So if you're looking at someone in a particular way, that is because of your past experiences, or you have built up, emotional built up, or your genetic built up, or the way you have grown up. These are various factors which affect us. Now, suppose we are able to remove those filters, what will happen? These impressions are removed. By technique, we remove these filters. Then we become like a baby, like a child, innocent child of 3 or 4 years, who is so innocent. And that's the status of us. We were like that when we were young. These impressions have made us what we are today. And that's the reason why we have all kinds of problems on the mind. So if you're able to remove those impressions, then we become totally innocent, child, pure, blind. So how do we do that? That's the technique which we talk about. Heartfulness way of meditation is that's what we do. Okay. We subtly remove the impressions from the subtle body in a process, in a technique, through a three-way method. First is meditation. It's a heart-based meditation in which we sit in a relaxed way in a chair so that the body is comfortable. If you're comfortable on a floor, we are welcome. Or if you're comfortable in a chair, you want to rest your back, you're welcome. And we focus our mind to your heart. This is a heart-based meditation. We believe that divinity is present in your heart. And if we try to bring our attention to your heart, we do not concentrate, bring our attention to our heart, with the thought that the divine source is present in the form of light in our heart. The second thing is we do what is known as cleaning. The most important part of this technique is this, the cleaning part. We remove those impressions deposited in our system through a process called cleansing or regeneration in the evening when we come back from work or when the day is over. Now the cleaning happens in three ways. One is the individual cleaning we do on a day-to-day basis. There is another way of cleaning, another technique, which is we have trainers. I'm a trainer myself. And like me, there are 10,000 trainers across India who will do a one-to-one session with you, either remotely or face-to-face. Remotely is a recent phenomenon because of COVID. Otherwise, it is always face-to-face. No charges are there. this voluntary work. We are all volunteers in this organization, all of us, and it is a non-profit organization. So the trainer will train, give you a deeper session of cleaning, and it will try to remove more deeper sanskaras. And the third is a group meditation or group training session, which happens on Sunday morning. And this group meditation is normally conducted by our master. We call him fondly as Daji, or his name is Sri Kamlesh Patel. He's based in Hyderabad. He's a US citizen and been a businessman. All of us are all, we have two lives. One is spiritual life and one is the material life. We all do our work and we also do spirituality. The third part of the technique is prayer. In the evening, when we go to sleep through a process of prayer, and we connect ourselves to the higher divine source. We actually literally let ourselves in the arms of the divine, saying that I'm surrendering myself to you. You are the taking care of me. We also let go of our desires, our unfulfilled aspirations, whatever it is there, we just let them go at the night, and we let ourselves totally surrender to the divine. And we get, and in that sleep, the deep sleep that we get, we are ready for the meditation next day morning. Now, these three processes are aided by a yogic process called pranahuti or transmission. This is the unique feature of our heartfulness meditation. And this is something which I would suggest you to actually experience. If I try to explain it to you, it will be like explaining a taste of mango. It cannot be. You have to taste. So it is the same thing here. You have to literally go through the process. And it's a very simple thing. I mean, you can just go to Google, just type heart spots, and you will find somebody, and just put your address, location where you are, and you will find somebody staying around you within a kilometer. Just call the person, call the trainer, and he will give a session. That's one way. Or another way is due to a HeartSap. There's an app on available on the mobile. It's called HeartSap. Just download the app, go online, and you'll find somebody, some trainer across the globe, any time of the day, 24/7. Even if you want a session at 12 o'clock at night, there will be somebody in the US who will be ready to give a session, the trainer. So absolutely no religion, no color, no caste, no kind of bar is there. This is open to everybody. We do a lot of such programs for children, for school, which is called a School Connect, University Connect, Village Connect, Government Connect. And we do essay events in association with United Nations. So now, this is something which I wanted to share with you all. And our website is heartfulness.org, very simple. Just Google, you will get to know everything about us. We have 1,600 acres township in Hyderabad, in Telangana, which is, it's a divine abode, you know. And it is something where, as Dr. Yugandhar said, to uplift the consciousness, you got to go and have a look at it. So coming to the concluding part, I would like to thank Dr. Yugandhar and his team and the World United for giving me this wonderful opportunity in this forum. He has rightly said that collective effort is required for upliftment of human consciousness. And all of us have to work together for this. And the only way is to join hands to move our human consciousness from animal human being to human being to divine human being. It's a collective effort, but it starts without injury. If we are at peace, we can bring peace to all of us. And well, that's my end of my topic. But if anybody has any questions or want to know, I mean, we're going to take it on later, I guess. So thank you very much, Sayukta ji.
Thank you so much, Datta Prasad sir. So when I was really young, from school, my mom used to take me to Heartfulness Center, I remember. And all you had to do is close your eyes and sit. And then you'll get some yummy food after you finish it. So,
yes.
Very, very cool. Nice experience. I still remember. And it was very refreshing. I used to go during the exam time. So I know.
Still, you are welcome even now.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much. Like you said, we'll definitely learn how to respond and not react. And there are so much imprints that you said so rightly from morning till night, whether it's the media, whether it's work, whether it's the entire pandemic. We require to clean ourselves from within. So this is like a nice
clean. We do a lot of physical cleaning, you know. We do a physical
cleaning. Absolutely. Clean our body. We clean our homes very much.
We clean our body, but what about
the housekeeping inside? Also. Right.
We have to clean our inside too.
Absolutely. Very beautiful message, sir. I just wanted to share our token of appreciation for giving us this clarity. This is to Datta Prasad's Bhonsle sir, the World United Presence Global Transformation Festival Certificate of Speaker, to Datta Prasad Bronsle, sir, for being an esteemed speaker in the Global Transformation Festival 2021. What a wonderful way to end 2021 with getting a great message to start our 2022. Really awesome. Thank you so much, sir. Thanks for being a part of our platform.